Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you two designs for simple stopwatches that can be used to measure time in Minecraft. The first one, as you can see here, is rather simple, resource friendly and pretty compact. So it's only 3 blocks long, 1 block wide and 3 blocks high, but it can be easily modified to be just 1 block high and 3 blocks wide. The downside to this design is that it can only be used to measure a time up to 128 seconds, which is roughly a bit more than 2 minutes. The second design is a bit more complex, has some redstone circuitry at the back here, is also 3 blocks wide, 4 blocks high, and 4 blocks long, or 5 blocks long if you count the levers in the front at the front here. But it has the advantage of maximum time of 1382.4 seconds, which is a bit more than 23 minutes, which should be enough for pretty much any kind of race you might want to time with this circuitry here. Okay, now what are the resources you will need? Again, you will need some kind of building block, of course. Then for the simple design, you will need 2 redstone torches, 2 lamps, 2 hoppers and 2 levers. Of course, the lamps aren't really needed. You can use normal blocks here, but it makes a bit more obvious which inputs are activated and which aren't. So it's more for display than actual use. And for the second design, you will need 4 redstone dust, 1 torch, 1 comparator, 2 optional redstone lamps, 2 droppers, 2 hoppers, 2 levers, and 4 chests. And of course you will need for both some kind of item that can be stacked up to 64 times and isn't too important for you. So something like cobblestone or something similar will also work here. Okay. So now that you know what those things here are and how much space you need and what resources you need, we can start with the actual building. Okay, so let's start with the first design. For this, just take 2 hoppers and run them into each other like this. And then grab a redstone lamp and place it either on top, at the bottom, or to the side of the first hopper. And then put a torch on the back of the lamp and a lever on the front of it. Now repeat this process once more, so I'll be putting it down here. You can also put it to the side, or you can put both of them to the sides, however you want to have it. And that's pretty much all of the redstone. Now all you have to do is put 5 stacks of items into the hopper at the back, and now the clock or the stopwatch is done. So basically, when both inputs are turned off like this, it will reset itself. If they are in opposite states like this or like this, the stopwatch is stopped. And if both are turned on, the items from the hopper at the back will be transported into the hopper in the front, and the stopwatch starts running. And basically all you have to do is take the number of items in here, divide it by 2.5, and then you have the amount of seconds that the timer has been running. And once you have your score or your time, you can just turn both off and then let it reset itself. Of course, you don't have to use a lever here. You can also run the output from an Aris flip-flop, for example, into one of those inputs here, and by using the R and the S input for the flip-flop, you can actually build some kind of automatic time measurement system for a race or something like this. So now, what is the maximum number of time, or the maximum time this circuit here can work with? Since it has 5 stacks of items here, the maximum time is 128 seconds, or a bit more than 2 minutes. If you need something for a bit longer time, you might want to use the second design I'll be showing you now. So my second design was actually inspired by a redstone stopwatch from Mumbo Jumbo, but it's a bit more compact and resource friendly. So let's start by placing 2 upwards facing droppers like this. Then grab a hopper and run it into the bottom dropper. Place 2 chests side by side on top of this hopper here, and finally another hopper facing into the chests like this. Then grab your last 2 chests and place them on top of the hopper and the droppers, just like this. Go to the back and place diagonally downwards behind the bottom dropper a block. Then go up and back again, place another block. Place a comparator in the subtraction mode in the gap. Then put a block on top of the comparator and 2 to the sides like this. Put 4 redstone dust on top of those blocks here. Now it's time for the inputs. Place 1 lamp besides the hopper here and another besides the chest with a redstone torch behind it. Finally put a lever on both lamps like this. And now that's pretty much all of the redstone. Now it's time to fill the bottom chest with some items. But first, activate this lamp here. The reason for this is that the item elevator here only works when a certain amount of items is in this dropper here. Actually, you can deactivate it when you put the items directly into the dropper down here. As you can see, now we have 22 items in here, but just fill it to the brim with items, just like this. And another one should be into this hopper. Perfect. So as you can see, we have 41 items in the dropper down here, 1 in the hopper here, and finally a full double chest of items up here. So now if you want to start measuring your time, all you have to do is first lock the hopper down here by activating this lamp here. And then when you want to start your time measurement, just activate this hopper here. As you can see, this lamp here, as you can see now, the items are transported into this chest here. And if you want to stop, just deactivate this here, and now you have your amount of items in here. And again, if you divide the amount of items here by 2.5, you get the measured time in seconds. And once you're done, just deactivate the lamp down here and the whole thing will get reset itself. Now, if you want, now how much time can you measure with this whole system? Due to the double chest full of items here, you have a maximum time of 1382.4 seconds, which is roughly 23 minutes of time you can measure with this system here. Okay. So that was how you can build my 2 simple stopwatches. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!